Now we'll look at some additional derivatives involving the natural log function, or log base e. Normally you'll be given two different forms of the derivative formula for the natural log function given here. Notice the first derivative formula is just for natural log x. The derivative of natural log x is equal to 1 divided by x, or 1 over x. And then we have the derivative of natural log u with respect to x equals 1 over u times u prime. So this formula here includes the chain rule where u would be a function of x. And this can also be written as u prime divided by u, but I like this form because it reinforces the idea that we're applying the chain rule. Now if you're ever in doubt whether you need to apply the chain rule, it would never be incorrect to use it. Notice if we tried to use the chain rule for natural log x, u would be equal to x, and u prime would just be equal to 1. Let's take a look at our first example. We have f of x equals 2 times natural log x. So f prime of x is going to be equal to 2 times the derivative of natural log x, which is 1 over x, or 1 divided by x. You can think of this 2 as being 2 over 1. So our derivative function is 2 divided by x. Our second function is f of x equals natural log 4x. So notice how we do have a composite function, where the inner function would be 4x, so we'll let u equal 4x. So once we identify u, we'll need to determine du dx, or u prime. So here u prime is equal to 4. So now we can rewrite this function as natural log u, and then apply our derivative formula, which includes the chain rule. So f prime of x is going to be equal to the derivative of natural log u with respect to x, which is 1 over u times u prime, which would be 1 over 4x times 4, or 4 over 1. Notice how these 4s simplify out, and we have f prime of x is equal to 1 divided by x. Now you might be wondering, how could the derivative of natural log 4x be the same as the derivative of natural log x? So I do want to show how you can determine this derivative using a second method. If we start with the original function f of x equals natural log 4x, we could write 4x as 4 times x, which should remind us that we could apply a property of logarithms to rewrite this log as a sum of two logs, and that property is given here below. So we could write f of x equals natural log 4 plus natural log x. And now if we take the derivative of the function in this form, we would have f prime of x is equal to the derivative of natural log 4. Well, natural log 4 is a constant, so this derivative is equal to 0, plus the derivative of natural log x, which is just 1 divided by x. So notice how the result is the same derivative function. First, where we applied the chain rule, and second, where we applied a property of logarithms and then found the derivative, and notice that in this form we did not have to apply the chain rule. So either method is correct, but it's probably more common to use this method here, where we apply the chain rule and then simplify the result. We'll take a look at more examples in the next video.